Come one, come all, to the most phenomenal, most extraordinary, most unimaginable puppet show you've ever experienced. Prepare for an astonishing adventure full of mystery, full of danger, and full of artistry, meant to astound the eye and capture the human soul. The name's Professor Greg. Welcome to the magical theater of the strange.
Hey guys, James here, aka Wade McGinnis. This is Gaming Theater, and today I'll be taking a look at Puppeteer on the PS3. Now, the best way to describe this game is a mix of Kabuki with a little bit of, like, Little Big Planet. Rack and ruin.
The moon realm was ruled by a beautiful goddess. But then, Little Bear, for whom the moon goddess had shown nothing but love, stole two of his mistress's precious possessions.
I'm gonna get him back.
Black moonstone and a magic pair of scissors known as calipers.
The scissors!
After declaring himself Moon Bear King, he invaded the goddess's castle, smashed the white moonstone to pieces.
Once upon a time, I once upon a now. This is my moon team. So just get to the part where I sound.
Right. Yes, of course.
Of course.
Wasn't everyone so very wowed when the moon goddess was obliterated? Wasn't it just great that the impressive Moonbear King gave a piece of the white moonstone to each of his generals? Screwing over the moon at large. Oh yes, the next 3 years were something special.
Screwing over everybody. Little Moonbear's a dick.
Where do I begin?
How about the hero? S? Hero time! Wow.
He was the Moon Realm's ruthless new king, and intended to keep it that way. So night after night, he spirited away the souls of children and locked them inside wooden
houses.
Who were doomed to defend Castle Grizzlestaff.
I think it's time we kick some ass, ladies and gentlemen.
And while tonight was no exception, it would prove to be quite exceptional.
Ah, here we go.
Oh, the poor dearie. Look, Ying-Yang, another day, another soul.
Poor indeed. You're as bad as the tyrant. How many of these children are you planning to parade off to certain mutilation?
Mutilation of a child?
Before you realize you're wasting your time.
Why, one more, and then another after that. As many as it takes me to get my hands on calipers.
These people are really evil.
That's nice.
And I love it. The cat is actually the voice actor behind,
meet our hapless hero, who's just been brought to life firmly in the Moonbear King's clutches.
Kutaro.
Hey.
Your soul was summoned here at my behest.
Really?
Kutaro, will you be my friend?
No, I said no!
Pals to the bitter end.
Yeah, totally. Bros. No! Yeah! Oh, you bastard! I'm amazed I survived. So therein lies the new mechanic. Your heads is your life. Lucky for you, you can get another one.
Another dunce who left his head in the Moonbear King's belly.
Hello?
You're going to drop dead if you go without a head.
I know.
And I'll be the one stuck with
clean. Well, give me a head, man.
Come on. Let's find something else you can use. A substitute head.
Give me it, right.
What's rattling around in there?
R2.
It's a head.
Give me.
Perhaps I'll just help my
Yes. This oh.
You're all set.
All
remember
right.
Those head parts. They flap around with lots of useful heads. But one little touch, and they'll drop their stash.
You it's like know, a piñata.
A new kid on the chopping block like you ought to have a couple of noggins, at least. Can't take any chances.
Oh, I'm...
There's a knock, see? Just like I said.
I got a spider on my head!
Blasted! What am I doing wrong? Am I not powerful enough?
This is
extremely.
If you pick up a lost head,
one false
before
move,
it vanishes, and
those
you
heads
can get it
of
back.
Yours will tumble right off your shoulders. If you don't grab them right away, their magic will fade and no more head. So remember, if you lose your head, pick it up.
Oh, he's an acrobatic man.
Oh, and one other thing. Moon sparkles. Here, I'll show you.
Alright. Okay.
Voila! These are moon sparkles.
Moon sparkles.
Collect 100, and you'll be able to magically come back to life.
I can't move.
Even if you do lose all your heads.
I can't move. I can't. Okay.
Let's keep looking.
Alright. So, are you guys starting to get an idea here that this is a very well-scripted, very artistic, very unique little experience, and it's very much reminiscent of Little Big Planet with a little bit of Kabuki, a lot of over-the-characterized, over-the-dramatic, just everything's over the top. And I'm not entirely against that, actually. Now, you can get this on the PlayStation Network, or you can actually just go buy it at the local store for $40. Oh.
The witch's bloomers.
You know, it's not exactly something I want to see. Alright. Anything? Oh, hey, hey. And, hey, come on, man. Oh, who's that? Hey, 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 hey.
Keep your eyes peeled for moon sparkles if you want to stay alive.
I'm getting down.
That moon bear king is always
so
angry.
Why is this guy helping?
Jehoshaphat. Ooh, look there. You see that head symbol? Listen, every head has a little bit of magic to it. They react to places and objects that resemble them. Oh, why don't you just give it a try? Here, first choose the right
head. Alright, how do I do that? Okay.
Now, use the head's meow jig.
Yeah.
Anyway, keep an eye out for those head symbols. Anything could happen.
Oh, 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 oh.
Look at that.
Dun, dun,
no
dun,
wonder
dun,
you're
dun,
so skinny.
Oh!
What a
little darling. Welcome. Please make yourself at home. Go and bring it to
She's
me.
She's gonna cook me. She's gonna cook me. Oh, oh, whoa, holy crap, that's a lot of love, whoa.
You'd better follow that fork. The witch doesn't take kindly to long waits. Watch that feisty fork. It's as wicked as the witch.
All right, oh, okay. Hang on, you know what we're gonna do real quick? I'm gonna go to options, and we are going to go to screen settings, subtitles, on. That way, just in case we miss a little bit of audio, we have it there, ready to go. Now, again, this actually does use the motion controller. I mean, personal experience, I've never really come across a single game that actually can do it well. And not to say that this game isn't one of those games that actually does motion control really well. I'm going to stick to the DualShock 3 because that is just, it's comfortable. And comfort matters in a game, ladies and gentlemen. Alright, hey, go, what are you going to do? Oh, you bastard!
I warned you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
Remember to pick that up quick. No more heads means no more. Pass through that shimmering gateway to proceed to the back of the
kitchen. All
right,
kitchen. Little boy.
Now, make no mistake. Kutaro was not alone in his plight. The kitchen was already staffed by unfortunates whom the Moon Bear King had plucked from their beds.
Yeah. And we got a little spiders. Oh, that's just creepy, isn't it, guys? Spider just kind of jumps on you like that? Yeah, that's on. Jump up here. Jump up here. And there we go.
These children have been charged with keeping the Fickle King fed. And it was a miserably hopeless task. After all, his appetite was as vast and insatiable as his lust for power.
Careful. There's this thing about fire and puppets.
I'm not a puppet man.
All those moon sparkles. You don't want to toast yourself grabbing them.
Okay. Ah! Ah! I'm... Ow! I lost my head. Get my head. There we go. We are good. This is an unusually interesting game. I love it.
Tykes and spending dusk till dawn getting kneaded and grated, peeled and parboiled, marinated, melted, minced and mashed. Or, if they were lucky, just zested, followed by a light grate.
Thank you, ladies. Oh. Anyone even notice that one? I didn't. I'm so glad that the children puppet are around to die for me, so I can learn.
I smell something delicious. The witch couldn't have made it.
Wait.
Oh, and that was my lunch. Oh, wait. There's that head symbol again.
Yes.
See how using your head can change the world? And I do mean that quite literally.
You are creepy, cat thingy. Do not realize this. When you were born, mother and father said he would be great for being creepy.
The witch, in case you're wondering, was a singularly screwy sorceress by the name of Esma Potts. You'd think someone that gifted with a cauldron would know a thing or two about
You would think.
And you'd be wrong.
Well, alright. Oh, damn it, I screwed up. Alright, here we go. Got my head. Yeah. Never leave home out of it. There we go. Moon sparkles on my head, actually.
As for Kutaro's catty companion, name of Yin Yang, he used to be the moon goddess's faithful feline. One might say his current mistress was a step down in some regard.
Oh. They're tempting me right there. That's all that really is. So I have quite a few heads.
Watch out for the vegetables. In this kitchen, the cook is a kook, and the squash are out to squish.
Come on, man, I missed a moon sparkle. My bad. That's fine.
Hurry along now, dearies, because lazy boys are the first to get turned into grubs.
Can she do that? Oh, I lost my head. Ah, got my head. I'm sorry, you fat lady. I was gonna say something else, I didn't.
Come hither, my pretties, so you can get lost.
Alright, you know what?
Ying Yang, open the windows. I'm roosting alive from this ghastly
one. Two, three. What do you think? Meowed by my cat-like reflexes?
Or... Wow.
Where is the moon goddess?
Hey.
I demand to know where you have taken
Who's that?
Her. Unhand me, you lout! How dare you?
That peppy princess ought to pipe down. Are you the new I suppose you want me to get your soul back so you can return home. Well, not until you march those wooden legs up to the Moon Bear King's throne room and fetch me his magic scissors.
Like I'm gonna give them to you.
You can do it. After all, you are a very special boy.
Oh, she makes me feel really
Deja
good.
Mew. How many very special boys are we up to now?
Yeah. You can keep him company.
Whoop-de-doo. We get to go to the throne room to find Calibros. Won't this be fun?
Wow. So she just keeps on doing this. She's a backstabbing witch who obviously wants power, and then she just, you know. Man, what a bitch. The fat beach. Ah, There we go. Oh, this is look. This looks
welcome
indeed
to the
awesome.
Tower of Tribulation.
Oh.
But don't let a cheerful name like that fool you. This scene, you never know where a head might be hiding.
All right.
Head pods, dreadnoughts, parking lots. Check everywhere. They don't say, get your head out of the gutter for nothing.
So there's a boss. There's another boss. Ow! You know, I kept my head. There's another boss. Now, apparently these bosses are so large that they almost... It's like fighting in Shadow of Colossus. No joke. Which is awesome. It really is. I love it. Whoa! That's a bat. Yes. Can I... I don't think I can hurt you. Yep. Don't worry. I don't plan on doing anything yet to you. Hey, little boy. It's like, stop it, man. Just... Let me go. Yep. Another... Another head. Awesome. I'm up to tres. So I can only have three heads currently right now on me. That's not bad. That's bad.
No, no, no,
that's a ball of children. Yay.
We have a spherical situation. Duck for your life before we get bowled over.
Oh god.
Whew. Still in one piece?
Not exactly.
Abracadabra.
Ah, there we go. Oh, Joe. I would really go for another head right about now. Yay. Speak of the devil. Alright, what does that do? Hi, mommy. Bonus stage. Did not know about this. So what do I do here? What?
Kutaro had been snatched away by an enormous arachnid.
Yeah, it's mummy.
But why didn't he end up as dinner? Perhaps the spider mistook Kutaro for one of her 10,000 children. Hard to keep track of all those little darlings, even with 8 eyes.
Well, yeah, because the stretch marks would be murder. Hello? Oh god. Bonus, bonus, bonus. Doing awesome, guys. Doing awesome here. So far, digging this game. This is an awesome game so far. And for 40 bucks, holy crap. Alright. Alright, make you mine. Alright, alright. I got a small bum. Got a small bum! Yes! Yes! And Wusha! We are mastering this game. I'm trying to avoid losing our heads. Again, art style. Oh, you bastards! Can't you see? I'm... Hey, I have a banana for a head. I'm not at all creeped out by this. So what do you do? Nice. I just split my banana. Sorry.
Magnificent, Kutaro. There's the entrance to the throne room. No one has ever made it this far.
Really? I wonder why. This is easy. Ah! Whew. This is one of the reasons why I love PlayStation more than Xbox. I hate to say it. Because you get games like this. Awesome. Oh, love interest.
Oh my gosh, are you crazy? Do you know who I am? Dad's gonna have a
sire. What if she's right? The sun does have a burning
temper. No kidding.
Ha! What could he do? I've got his precious daughter.
Well, of course you do, sire. And even if you didn't, your majesticalness is more than enough to eclipse the sun.
I've
Does he got
a very special
Oh, he's got a broken tooth, guys. You see that?
For
the lion.
So
a broken tooth.
I insist. Take a long
My god. Can you imagine having a cat like that?
Meow. What luck. He's left Calibras unattended for once. Kutaro, you are one lucky person.
Alright, which key is it? No, it's not keys. It's the awesome scissors! Oh my god! It's like Kingdom Hearts.
Our hero towered the most impressive pair of scissors you've
no
ever
kidding.
Seen. The legendary Calibras. But Calibras was bound fast by vile vines, the twisted offspring of the Moonbear King's twisted
Ah, time to snip snip, buddy.
Kutaro, meet Calibras. Calibras is a cut above your average scissors. He used to serve the Moon Goddess.
Step forward, boy.
Oh, God.
And take your destiny now.
Anyone else getting the severe impression of Harry Potter?
Now that's a shock. I mean, an honor. Don't you see? Calibras has chosen
I got the touch. Take it, my boy. And lose your head.
And so Kutaro's fortunes were starting to look up. After all, he was now the proud owner of a pair of enchanted scissors.
So why do they look so boring?
Still, it wasn't all good luck. Remember, Calibras belonged to the Moon Bear King.
Time to snip snip a bear's, power. Yeah, not really, but...
And the boy's first challenge was to extricate himself from the booby trap he just set off.
Rapid. Yes, thank you.
That's the ticket.
Aha!
Nicely done, Kutaro.
I'm so good at this.
We'll be out of here in no time.
Yes, and straight up. Hang on.
Yes.
Can I get the head? Hey, you smacked that, buddy. Oh! So if you don't get it right away, it actually comes right back.
Oh, scissored like a true wizard.
I'm so glad you didn't say anything else. So, that's... Do I want another banana head? I guess I'll have another banana head.
See? Take good care of Calibras, and Calibras will take care of you. Oh, lovely. Nice.
And we are in. What'll happen? Don't know, but... Oh, God! Oh, my God! That is awesome.
Who dares lay a hand on my property? My traps! How did you get out? Wait, how did you get out?
I knocked.
You wretch! What have you done to disrupt my throne room? Guards! Apprehend that!
Guards? Oh! Oh, I'm...
Deftly and
oh God.
The grubs descended upon
us.
But locked within each of them was the soul of a child just as scared as him.
Alright. I will free you.
That's it. Very
what did I do?
I'll pop your head clean off your shoulders.
Oh, I feel horrible.
Get caught and you'll be grabified, just like the rest of these poor
yes!
children.
I want that sticky fingered scoundrel.
I don't have
head.
Sticky fingers. I have. Ah, there we go. Wooja! And wooja!
Guards? Guards!
Ah.
Do it myself.
Oh, hey, whoa. What? Oh, down.
It was a
weave. What is a weave? Ow!
The Moon Bear King's
I got my head back.
Magical creations, weavers were some of the nastiest.
Ah! Oh my god! What's the matter, mate? Woohoo! Oh, I love this game so far. Oh, you got your stuff back, eh?
This was Kutaro's first ever real dose of fear. But to escape the Weaver, those fears would need to be conquered.
Don't worry, man. I'm good. I'm cutting him good.
As the clash grew even clashier, the boy slipped, sliced, and sundered with the cold realization his life counted on it.
So all of these... So a Weaver's actually a whole bunch of kids. Oh, this is a really dark kind of game.
With the legendary
oh, and I got a crown.
Kutaro had taken the first step of his grand adventure.
Yeah, hail to the king, baby. Hail to the king. All right, so what do I do? Oh. I die.
Unfortunately, the next steps had to be taken at a run, as the savage king was hot on our hero.
Yep, time to bail. Time to bail. Don't stand around. Time to bail.
Yes, sire.
Where did that whelp go?
Well, he can't have gotten far, sire. He has such tiny legs. I imagine he's right around the corner. I
don't this is expertly done, ladies corner. And gentlemen.
I want him.
Oh my god, that's awesome.
Find that thief, or I'll find someone who...
Oh, oh his weight.
Sire, your blood pressure. I'll take care of it.
Would
you like a back drop?
My back.
A glass of warm milk. Everything
much better. I can breathe.
Bravo, Kutaro. None of the others ever made it half as far. This will be music.
Well, I'm not going to give these scissors to the witch. No.
Oh, man up, would you please? Would you prefer the grubs find you and the Moon Bear King yanks your
No, but I'd rather actually give this back to, like, the Moon Queen. Goddess. Whatever. The one who owns it. Originally owns it. Oh. Did Oh, it's saving. I was like, oh, no. And something happened.
With a flash of Calibris, Kutaro felled the frightful monster and freed the soul of every last
child. Do I have access to this?
In the fiend's clutches.
No, I don't.
Well done, Kutaro. The souls he freed were homeward bound.
A lot of parents just got really happy right now. All right. That is probably one of the coolest looking maps I've ever seen in a game. Curtain one.
Kutaro had obtained Calibris, a legendary pair of magic...
Alright guys, you know what? This is a good stopping point for this episode.
Join us again for Act 1
season. I will definitely be hitting this up more often. I will definitely be doing a now playing of this entire game this, as a full series. So hopefully you guys liked, enjoyed. Leave a comment below. Let me know if you've even tried this, even if you've heard of this at all. And as always, catch you next time. Yep.